Good morning, all of you. In this session, we are going to start with CSIR NET GRF Chemical Science, December 2015. Part B, Series 2 is going to be discussed. Earlier, we completed 2016, 17, 18, 19 academic year question papers of both the sessions, June and December, of CSIR NET GRF Chemical Science. All are available on the channel called World of Competitive Chemistry. All detailed solved question papers are available. This will be very much fetching for reception towards any competitive exam and also any entrance examination as well, right? So let us enter into our actual concept, what we are going to discuss today. Here is the CSIR NET GRF Chemical Science December 2015, Part B, Series 2, questions from 36 to 55 are going to be covered now. Let us go with question number 36. The metallic radii are abnormally high for which of the following pairs? When we are taking all lanthanide elements like europium, ytterbium, samarium, terbium, gadolinium, lutetium, neodymium, holmium. These are the metal combinations are given. From this, where the abnormality is observed when compared to its theoretical or expected value, okay? So when we go with this europium and ytterbium, being europium is a F7 system with a D0 and S2 electronic configuration, right? F7, D0, S2 electrons will be there. Ytterbium consists of F14, D0 and S2 electron system will be there. Means D electrons are not there, but it will be half filled. Europium will be half filled. Ytterbium will be completely filled electronic configuration without a D orbital. Where D orbital will be present, 5D shell is the D orbital. And being F orbital is inner transition. So that will be still inner. So which is underlying shell, that's the reason why what happens, size will be deviated when compared to the theoretical value. That's the reason why for metals like europium and ytterbium, their theoretical and practical abnormality of their radius will be observed. That is purely because of electron missing in this 5D shell. Actually, what is the general electronic configuration of F block elements? N-2, F1 to 14 electrons should be present, and N-1, D 1 to 10 electrons should be there. Sorry, only D2, right? Only D1 electron will be there. And NS2 electrons will be there. This is the general electronic configuration of A block elements. Okay. Being A block elements are inner. So inner transition, what happens? We have to assign electrons into this inner shell because of high energy electrons of filling S orbital and N-1 D orbital. Now electron enters into this N-2 level, right? So here, in case of these these 5D electrons are missing, that's the reason why size abnormality is observed. For question number 36, option number 1 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 37. Identify two enantiomers among the following. What is the relation for enantiomers? Both the forms are mirror images to each other, and when we superimpose, both should be non-superimposable. Okay, so here these are the forms provided, and here we have methyl, here also methyl, bromo. Here bromo is towards the VR, here the bromo is away from the VR. Both are said to be mirror images to each other, and here bromo is a wedge bond, bromo is a dotted bond, the hydrogen is a wedge bond, methyl on the plane. So here interchange between these two observed from this A and B. So purely these two put on the vertical plane like a two-dimensional Fisher formula, you can clearly observe that both are mirror images and non-superimposable to each other. So by this, you can clearly confirm that A, B are said to be enantiomers. Non-superimposable mirror images are called enantiomers. When we take option number C and D, if you observe, CH3 is there, here BRH are interchanged, okay? Here BR is there, CH3, these groups. So when we take C and 180 degrees rotation, that will give the exactly identical D. So if identical is obtained, those two are said to be homomers. But exceptionally AB are not having that kind of provision. That's the reason why we can say AB are enantiomers, CD are homomers. So AB are provided in option number 1. So option number 37, option number 1 is the correct answer. Let us move on to next question. Again, it is a part of organic chemistry. The major product formed in the following reaction. We are taking cyclopentene. Cyclopentene with a CH2OH functional group on that. This is called allyl hydroxy compound. So double bond followed by CH2OH if present, that is called allyl hydroxy. And it is treated with COCl whole twice, DMSO. DMSO being it is a solvent, here it also used to facilitate the reaction working like a catalyst also. Here the temperatures are extremely low, like minus 60 to 0 degree centigrade temperature will be operated in order to carry this reaction. Simply we can say it is a kind of nucleophilic substitution, so that hydroxy will be replaced with chlorofunctional group. Finally, we will get chlorinated compound. Let us see the mechanism in order to obtain this final product. We are taking starting material, that is cyclopentene with CH2OH, which is treated with DMSO. DMSO is nothing but dimethyl sulfoxide will be treated. So when dimethyl sulfoxide is treated, what happens? Hydrogen replaced with S, S methyl sulfonium ion. So it will be generated. Now it is added with chloride. Being it is a SN2 type of mechanism, simultaneously detachment and attachment of the functional groups are possible, and we will get the final product, that is chloro-substituted product. The chloro-substituted product is given of a 4. So it is a kind of SN2 displacement DMSO by chloride ligand, right? So here option number 4 is the correct answer for question number 38. Let us move on to question 39. Again, it is a part of organic chemistry. The major product formed in the following reaction. We are taking the chain of 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon chain was given, and here 2 bromos are present, and here double bond O is there. It is treated with sodium methoxide. Whenever sodium methoxide was treated, sodium methoxide being it is a strong base, it used to pull the H plus and carbene will be generated, and it will be added with methoxide so that we will get methoxy substituted product. This bromo is eliminated, here the double bond formation, and this bromo is eliminated, here methoxy substitution is possible. Means one end it is converted into olefinic bond. That means in the presence of sodium methoxide, here it is worked like a dual role is played by the sodium methoxide. What is the dual role? Sodium methoxide is a being it is an eliminating agent, it used to generate the olefinic double bond. In another side, it is releasing OME, that means methoxide. So nucleophile will be added. So it working like a base as well as nucleophile in this reaction. Right. So being it is the base used to pull that and olefinic double bond generated, and methoxide when released so that nucleophilic substitution also possible. So final product will be option number 3. For question number 39, option number 3 is the correct answer in this. Let us move on to question number 40. The major product formed in the following reaction. We are taking the long chain having O benzoyl. Benzoyl is nothing but benzene ring with CH2 is called benzoyl group. CH2C. Dimethyl, this is geminal dimethyl group is there. Here we have carbonyl group and a double bond N2. Double bond N2 being it is a better leaving group used to originate. Always whenever double bond N2 is there, always it used to give the carbene, right? So whenever this compound is treated with rhodium OAC taken 4, rhodium taken twice, OAC taken 4, in the presence of CH2Cl2, that means dichloromethane under reflux conditions. What is reflux condition? Heating the solvent to its boiling point temperature is said to be reflux conditions. And the rhodium to OAC taken 4 was transition metal complex was taken as a catalyst in order to facilitate this reaction. So carbene will be generated, that carbene will participate in the ring cyclization so that 5-membered ring origination is possible. And subsequently, we will get the product. Then we have to check which is a suitable product through the mechanism. If we take this double bond N2 in the presence of rhodium OAC taken 4, it will facilitate the elimination of nitrogen as the gaseous product, so that carbene intermediate will be generated. It will be cyclized at the center so that we will get the cyclic product. The 5-membered cyclic product will be generated with a ether linkage. And here we have benzoyl group, right? BN denotes benzoyl, that is represented as CH2PH. And this is the option which is provided in second one. Simple carbene generation followed by ring cyclization, that is given in the option number 2. For question number 40, option number 2 is the correct answer. Let us move on to 41. The major product formed in the following reaction. We are taking cyclopentene system, and here we have a olefinic double bond. Here CH2O, COET, CH2Br is there. Tributyl tin hydride, N-tributyl tin hydride in the presence of AIBN is added. AIBN is the reagent. Here is the abbreviation for that. Azobis-dibutyryl nitrile is called AIBN. So it used to generate the carbon free radical, so that entire mechanism proceeded with carbon free radical. So here, a PHH is nothing but benzene. So, and we are maintaining the temperature 80 degrees, and Zons reagent is added. Zons reagent is the oxidizing agent. Now let us see what will be the product from this 5-member ring structure. So in order to get that, first we are taking this 5-member ring structure with a side chains which are given within the problem, and added with tributyl tin hydride, being it is the hydrogen free radical donor. It will use to participate in cleavage of this carbon bromo functional group, so that carbon free radical bromine free radical will be generated. The bromine free radical can bonded with this hydrogen. Finally, we will remove this HBr. Here it used to remove this HBr. Here carbon free radical is originated. Generated carbon free radical now binded to this olefinic double bond. Again, here the cleavage or homolytic fission of the bond is possible. Subsequently, hydrogen will be added at this position. So this entire mechanism proceeded with free radical, being AIBN is a free radical facilitator, right? After getting that kind of 7-membered ring structure, now we are going with the Zones oxidation. Zones oxidation will contract the ring size, so that here what happens, this ring opening kind of reaction is possible, and being 7-membered highly sterically strained one, so that it will be rearranged within the molecule, and the 2 5-membered ring structures containing compound will be originated. That is provided in option number 1. So here for question number 41, option number 1 is the correct answer. Let us discuss the mechanism in brief. We are taking tributyl tin hydride. Tin hydride is the H dot donor, hydrogen free radical donor. In the presence of AIBN, reaction mechanism proceeded with free radical, so that carbon bromo bond will be cleaved and carbon radical bromine radical will be generated. So carbon radical can bind with this carbon, so that here 7-membered ring structure will be generated. 7-membered ring is highly sterically strained, and that subjected to Jones oxidation, so that ring contraction is possible, and subsequently it rearranged within the molecule by the process called oxidation, so that we will get bicyclic 5-membered ring system. That is given in the option number 1. For question number 41, option number 1 is the correct answer. Then let us consider the stereochemistry also. Here already existing group is towards the viewer with the wedge bond. Obviously, whatever ring coming will tilted in such a manner, one of the bond is moving away from the viewer indicated by the dotted line. Right. So for question number 41, option number 1 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 42. Question number 42 again is a part of organic chemistry. The major product A and B in the following reaction. Okay, what is A, what is B, we have to predict. Okay, so here in case of A, we are taking cyclohexane with isopropyl methyl substitutions. Isopropyl methyl substitutions are present, and here we have quaternary nitronium, and it is treated with 180 degrees. The compound A, and one more compound is given, this is cyclohexane methyl and isopropyl groups. Quaternary nitronium will be there, and we are maintaining the temperature of 160. Then what is the product we have to depict, right? So in case of starting molecule, so what it will do, so in order to in order to understand the mechanism. This molecule can be written in the form of chair form. That is a convenient stable form for this one. Whenever chair form was written, being nitronium, quaternary nitronium is highly unstable and the better leaving group. When we are maintaining the temperature of 180 degrees, it will be discarded. So that adjacent bond will be, adjacent hydrogen bond will be shifted and hydrogen abstracted by oxide. O minus is there on this nitrogen. So here there is a origination of double bond and without affecting any stereochemistry. Whatever initial stereochemistry is there, that will be retained. Retention of the stereochemistry is possible. We are not going to move any position of already existing methyl and isopropyl groups. So that option number A is the correct one, is provided in one, even in the third one. But in third one, they are mentioning that A, B, both are identical. So both are used to give the identical product. Let us see whether it is visible or not. For that purpose, second one here, being carbo isopropyl and nitrogen, quaternary nitrogen, both are bulky, both are highly bulky, and so they are oriented away from the wear. Both are bulky and present on the adjacent carbon atoms. It is not at all favorable. That's the reason why immediately this isopropyl group changed to plane. So it will be changed to plane, and here at 160 degrees, what happens? More substituted alkene will be favorable because there is a inversion in the stereochemistry. Initially daughter line bond is there, now it moved on to a plane. So that is purely because of minimizing the steric strain. Okay, and after the removal, whatever alkene generated, that is highly stable because more substituted alkene is more stable in accordance with CJF rule, right? So that is provided in option number B. But in case of first case, we are taking 180 degrees, right? At that high temperature, what happens? Molecule is being, it is excited more so that here the double bond, which is least substituted, will be favorable. So at low temperature, most substituted will be favorable. That is provided in option number one. For question number 42, option number one is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 43. It is a part of carbohydrates, biomolecules, organic chemistry. D monos upon reflexing in acetone with a copper sulfate and a sulfuric acid. Whenever any hydroxy compound treated with aldehyde or ketone, what happens? Initially it able to form hemiacetol. And if it is treated with two moles, hemiacetol turned into acetol. But acetone binded with adjacent two hydroxy functional groups so that there is a formation of a cyclic ring is possible. That's why whatever product generated is said to be acetol structure that is obtained from this mannose. What is mannose? Mannose is a carbohydrate. There, aldehexose will be there. So mannose and glucose both are said to be anomers. Right? So mannose and glucose both are said to be anomers. Anomers are nothing but which are having similar molecular formula, similar kind of arrangement of all the functional groups except only one carbon atom. One carbon stereochemistry will be varied, remaining entire structure remains same. Those are called anomers. Hence, glucose and the mannose are said to be anomers. And here, when it's subjected to reaction with acetone, what happened? That used to form the acetol kind of structure, that will be the cyclic structure. Let us see what is the correct one. This is the mannose structure where we are taking in the cyclic chair form. It is represented in cyclic chair form, right? So it can be represented. The six-membered ring can be concised into furanose structure. This is called a pyranose ring. We can write this pyranose into furanose ring by contracting the size of the ring. Here is the six-membered furanose. Cyclic ether is there. Here it turned into 5-membered ring cyclic ether system. And here is the side chain OH-OH. Being these two are required for the participation in the acetone reaction. So here acetone will be added. Acetone, what is the acetone structure? CH3, C double bond O, CH3. Double bond O group is there. Here hydrogen will be departed from the system entirely. Water molecule will be eliminated. We will get the cyclic acetol form in the adjacent carbon atom. That is provided in option number and even 4 also it is provided, but there is one mistake. What happens here also, one more molecule. So they treated with two molecules of acetone. But in case of this, if we see this, in this terminal center, this hydroxy is not in the favorable position for the reaction. Only there is a provision. Here you can clearly observe from this furanose form, you can clearly observe these two adjacent hydroxy are suitable for the reaction with acetone, and these two hydroxy also suitable for the reaction with acetone. Here you can discard one water molecule, here also one water molecule will be discarded, and here another acetol will be generated. Here we formed acetol, and in this side chain also acetol will be formed. This OH will not be reacted. What could be the reason? Because this OH not laying on the plane, it is away from the plane. Its stereochemistry is not correct. That's the reason why option number 4 may not be correct. So this is not in the suitable orientation. So even in this option number 2 is also, it is zigzagly arranged. Only one acetol is formed. This is not at all correct. Even in the option number 1, only one acetol is formed. There is a provision for two acetol formation, means two acetone molecules will be reacted. One is side chain acetol, and either is in between acetol. Two acetol formation is possible. That is provided in option number 3. For question number 43, option number 3 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 44. The major product formed in the photochemical reaction of 2E4Z6CA decatriene is. So we are taking a system with the 3 double bonds. So let us see what is the structure. So this is a stereochemistry what they mentioned. So this compound will participate. If you see this here, you can clearly observe one works like a diene, another dienophile is there. Internal disulfur reaction is possible. So two conjugated system works like a diene, another terminal alkene will work like a dienophile, so that internal disulfur reaction will be performed, so that here it will be participate in the ring cyclization, and here we will get a cyclic 6-membered system, and two adjacent alkyl groups should be transferred with respect to each other in order to minimize the steric strain. Whenever molecule is formed, that should be with the minimum repulsive forces and maximum energy. So whatever molecule always tends to attain the stability, that is provided in option number 1 rather than option number 2. Option number 2, two alkyl groups are inclined towards the VR. So being both are bulky, that is unfavorable condition. And moreover, option number 3, 4, we have 4-membered ring structure. Always 4-membered ring structure is highly sterically strained in accordance with Bayer's. Right. So here only the possible option is option number 1. For question number 44, option number 1 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 45. Again, it is a part of organic chemistry. The correct statement about the following reaction is, we are taking narbornine system with a double bond on N2. So narborna ketone is given, and a methanol photochemical conditions, light irradiation is possible. Then what is the product A? In order to get this, whenever double bond N2 is there and light irradiation, always the reaction mechanism proceeded with carbene intermediate. Here the generation of carbene intermediate is possible. Carbene intermediate is possible, that is given in option number 1. Nitrene may not be possible. Nourish 1 type, nourish 2 type is also not possible. Only from this functional group, you can directly understand there is a mechanism for carbene, and the product will be A. A product will be 1. So let us see the entire mechanism so that it will be very clear to us. So if we irradiate this narbornine system with a light, so that here the origination of carbene, that carbene further involved in ring opening reaction, so that ketene will be formed. So carbon-carbon double bond, subsequently carbon-oxygen double bond is called a ketene system. Ketene system further added with protic solvent, that is methanol. Methanol is added to the system. When methanol is added, this double bond O now turned into ester functional group. Now ring contracted narbornine system was obtained. Initially narbornine, now it is converted into contracted structure with the carbene intermediate formation. That is provided in option number 1. For question number 45, option number 1 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 46. Again, it is a part of spectroscopic analytical technique. The structure of compound that matches with proton NMR data given below. proton and NMR recorded in DMS4D6 butyrate was taken here, and the peaks are appeared at 7.75. 7.75 is the characteristic peak for aromatic hydrogen, and the J value is 8.8, is mentioned, 2.4 hedges. So this will correspond to only one hydrogen. 7.58 also denotes what? Aromatic hydrogen. How many? Only one. 6.7 also denotes one hydrogen. This indicates again it is the a part of aromatic ring system. 6.5 corresponds to two hydrogens singlet. It is very clear that NH2 functional group. So this is a kind of NH2 functional group. Two hydrogens with one singlet, that denotes what? NH2 functional group. Then three hydrogens, 3.8, obviously it is methoxy. Let us predict where all these are present. 7.75, neither is 7.58, 6.7. Three aromatic hydrogens should be present. In the compound number one, we have three aromatic hydrogens. Compound number two also have three aromatic hydrogen. Compound number three, three aromatic hydrogens. Compound number four also have three aromatic hydrogens. This is not suitable data for us in order to predict the structure. Then 6.5, two hydrogens, amine. Where amine is there? Compound one amine is there, compound two amine is there, compound three amine is there, compound four also amine is there. There is also no clue for us. Then let us go with third one, methoxy. That methoxy 3.8. This 3.8 denote that methoxy is adjacent to NH2 functional group. In general, methoxy characteristic peak will be 3.6. But so whenever it is in adjacent to NH2 group, so that it will appear at 3.8, that is provided in option number 2. Option number 2, we got the correct answer. Let us see the exact position of the peaks. Here is the hydrogen. Here is the hydrogen. Here is the hydrogen corresponds to 7.57, 7.55, 6.78. So amine group obviously will give singlet. It will give a singlet only, being two hydrogens are identical set. We can say only one singlet is possible for this, and around 6.5 we will get the signal. And here OCH3 obviously will give 3.6 a characteristic, being it is in the adjacent position to NH2, hence we got 83.8. So by this all data, we got option number 2 is the correct answer. For question number 46, option number 2 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 47. So match the following question was given here. Three different compounds P, Q are provided. All are cyclic lactones. All cyclic lactones are giving their characteristic signals in the IR spectrum at 1750, 1770, 1800. Which compound will give? Which kind of peak we have to predict? First one is the cyclic lactone. The cyclic lactone having conjugation of non-bonding electrons with this double bond O electrons. So N to pi star transition is possible in case of compound number P. So here these electrons having somewhat no other conjugation except N to pi. So that here 1770 centimeter inverse stretching frequency will be observed for this first compound. And the second compound, so conjugation not at all present here. Double bond is there. Here also double bond is there. But both the double bonds are non-conjugated system. Non-conjugated systems are highly unfavorable, and this leads to the peak at 1800 centimeter inverse. This will give at 1800. When we see compound number C, where conjugation is there between two pi bonds, this pi bond and this pi bond both are alternatively arranged. Alternatively arranged pi bonds are having more provision for the excitation, and it requires the least energy for the stretching. That is given at 1750. P with Y, Q with Z, R with X, that is provided in option number 1. For question number 47, option number 1 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 48. It is a part of natural products. Alpha pinene, it is a terpene system. The number of chemical shifts non-equivalent to protons expected for proton NMR spectrum of alpha pinene. So alpha pinene is the bicyclic ring system with two geminal methyl groups. Right here, we have to predict how many equivalent set of hydrogens and subsequently how many proton NMR signals are possible for this compound. Let us write the structure in the detailed form. Here is the structural representation. Here we have two methyl groups and this second cyclic ring. So all the hydrogens present in the ring structure are said to be indistinguishable, so that here there is a possibility of first set, second, and the third, fourth is there, fifth is there, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. These many type of hydrogens are available within the molecule, so that alpha pinene, being it is a bicyclic ring system with one double bond, three methyl groups within the cyclic ring, we are able to get 10 equivalent set of protons. Subsequently, 10 signals are appeared for this compound. For question number 48, option number 4 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 49. In the mass spectrum of 1,2-dichloroethane, approximate ratio of peaks M by Z values 9800, 102 will be. So 1,2-dichloroethane was taken. It is the system of chloro. When we go with M by Z values, there are certain guidelines we have to, in order to predict the product structure, certain guidelines are there. So for chloro compound, we have to employ the formula A plus 3B square. For this dichloroethane, we can apply the formula A plus 3B square. So here, if we expand this one, what happens? A square plus 9B square plus 6AB will be given. A plus 3B square formula can be employed, so that peak intensity ratio will be 9:6:1. So 9:6:1 provided in option number 2. For question number 49, option number 2 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 50. It is a part of organic chemistry again. The major product formed in the following reaction. We are taking a six-membered ring with a chloro and CF3, trifluoromethane. And here a secondary amine is there, which is already added with this diester. Diester compound is also there. So now it is added with diphenyl ether under reflex conditions. So diphenyl ether is a solvent. Reflex is the temperature condition we are maintaining. So that the molecule participate rearrangement within the molecule rearrangement is possible without any addition or deletion. Let us see how the reaction proceeded. So for that purpose, the mechanism is given. So it will participate in the ring cyclization, because here we have a double bond O OME is there, that double bond O group participate. So C double bond O OME is there, OME group will be discarded and it will be cyclized at the center with the six membered ring formation. Here is the formation of double bond O. Here double bond is there, NH group is there, COO ME group already existing at this position. So here six membered ring structure, which is provided only in the option number, that is provided only in the option number 4. So for question number 50, option number 4 is the correct answer, where we are getting how it is possible. This methoxy will be discarded and the C double bond O group will be added at this position. It will be cyclized so that six membered ring structure will be generated. So for question number 50, option number 4 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 51. The major product formed in the following reaction is, what is the major product we have to depict? We are taking a long chain hydrocarbon with a, here are two double bonds. Here is another double bond with COOME. So it's very clear that it is a part of Diels-Alder reaction photochemistry. 150 degrees temperature is employed so that it will participate in the ring cyclization by Diels-Alder reaction. Diels-Alder reaction is nothing but 1,3 butadiene treated with dienophile with electron deficient functional groups upon that, so that ring cyclization got carried and we will get the final product. So here is the system. In all the cases, we are getting a bicyclic ring system with a 6-membered and 5-membered, but only the change in stereochemistry. So let us go with this one. Initially, we are taking the system which can be represented in the synchronized form in order to get the product in an easy way. So synchronized form in the sense suitable orientation of all the functional groups in order to attach, right? So here, COOME is indicated with the wedge bond because it is away from the beer. It's subjected to 150 degrees rotation whenever it is rotated so that it is in the suitable form for the cyclization. Upon cyclization, COOME is away from the beer. So, and adjacent carbon, bridged carbon hydrogen also away from the beer. And here we got double bond, being it is cyclized by the Diels-Alder reaction, so that a 6-membered and 5-membered ring system got generated. And that is exactly provided in option number 1. So stereochemistry is also exactly matching. So for question number 51, option number 1 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 52. We are taking alpha beta unsaturated hydroxycyclohexane, and it is treated with CH3COET taken thrice H plus and heated at 200 degrees centigrade temperature. So what will be the final product we have to depict? Whenever this 200 is employed, what happens here? The dehydration carried, and here we will get a double bond system, and the origination of carbocation is possible. Carbocation generation is possible that will participate reaction with the reagent whatever provided here, so that we will get the product COOET. COOET is generated at this position. So the stereochemistry will be wedge bond ester group is generated at this position. For question number 52, option number 3 is the correct answer, right? Here we have double bond OH group and CH3COET taken thrice upon H plus, treating with H plus. What H plus will do? H plus will be attached to OH, and here oxonium will be generated, that will be discarded. Here carbocation will be formed. Generated carbocation will shift this double bond, so that here the double bond origination and carbocation will be generated at this center. Generated carbocation will be treated with this compound, what we have, CH3COET taken thrice. And the same carbon OET taken thrice, three OET groups are there, one of the OET eliminated, we will get the carbon oxygen double bond. That being it works like a nucleophile, it will be bonded to this carbon atom, subsequently turned into an ester functional group. So the ester generated at the center. For question number 52, option number 3 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 53. It is a part of chemical kinetics. Concentration of reactant R varies with the time for two different reactions. One of the reaction, that is rate of the reaction versus time. Second is 1 by rate of the reaction versus time. Rate of the reaction versus time, we got the negative slope. 1 by rate of the reaction versus time, we got the positive slope, which is passing with some extent of intercept value. Then what are the rate of the reactions for these two we have to depict? So it's a very simple, because based on the direct chemical formula, these equations are provided. For zero order reaction, concentration of A is given by A naught minus NKT. So here, that is nothing but slope minus NK will be there. If the equation is in the form of, what is the equation? Concentration A is equal to A naught minus NKT. What is the form of equation? Y is equal to MX minus C. If Y is equal to MX minus C is there, what negative slope will be there? That is zero order reaction. That is the first equation, first plot. And let us go with second one. So 1 by A is equal to 1 by A naught plus NKT. 1 by A is equal to 1 by A naught plus NKT. This is the equation is in the form of Y is equal to MX plus C. If MX plus C is there, that is having positive slope. So here we have the value 1 by A is equal to 1 by A naught. That means 1 by R versus time was plotted exactly. It is a second order reaction. First plot depicts first plot denotes zero order. Second plot denotes second order. So that zero and second order provided in option number 3. For question number 53, option number 3 is the correct answer. And then let us move on to question number 54. For a simple cubic crystal, the angle between 201 plane and XY plane is, okay. So 201 Miller indice is provided and XY plane is there. For that purpose, what is the angle? What is the angle we have to depict? It is a part of solid state chemistry, where the formula for the prediction of formula for the prediction of angle is it is given as 201 Miller plane and 001 Miller plane was given. Cos theta is equal to H1 H2 plus K1 K2 plus I1 I2 by root H1 square plus K1 square plus I1 square. Root H1 square plus K1 square plus I1 square was given, right? Here H1 denotes what? This first term present in this. H2 denotes what? First term present in this. K1 denotes what? Second term present in this first plane. So K2 denotes the second term present in second plane. L1 is nothing but first one. L2 is nothing but second one, right? So this is about, here we can take a 2 into 0. Here is the 2, here is a 0. Here is 0, here is 0. Plus 0 into 0, 1 into 1. 1 into 1. These are called H into H, K into K, L into L. 2 into 0 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into 1 by root. H1 square. H1 is nothing but 0 square. So K1 square, 0 square. L1 square, 1 square. So 1 square nothing but 1 itself. Next term, root term. H1 square means 2 square. 2 square is nothing but 4. K1 square, nothing but 0 square. 0 square also 0. L1 square, 1 square. 1 square again becomes 1 itself, right? So now cos theta is equal to, cos theta is equal to 2 into 0, 0, right? Plus 0 plus 1 means only 1 will be there on the numerator. 1 by root, 1 by root 0 plus 0 plus 1. Root 4 plus 0 plus 1, nothing but root 5. 1 by root 5 is the value at denominator, right? So 1 by root 5 value will be 0.448. 0.448. Okay. So cos 45 is given by 1 by under root 2. In the similar way, we can employ for this also. So when we apply, cos 45 is given by 1 by root 2. Cos 60 is given by 1 by 2. So when we see these two, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2 is there. 1 by 2 value will be lesser when compared to 1 by root 2. Because, so here root 2 value, as the denominator decreases, numerator value will be rise. That's why it will be greater than 60 degrees. It will be greater than 60 degrees. For question number 54, option number 4 is the correct answer. Let us move on to question number 55, chemical kinetics question. For the reaction, A gives rise to 2B, B gives rise to C. A gives rise to 2B proceeded with K1 rate of the reaction. Then 2B to A proceeded with K inverse rate of the reaction. B to C proceeded with K2 rate of the reaction. Now dB by dt is given by, we have to depict what is the differential of dB. That means dB by dt should be predicted. So here half dB by dt is equal to K1A minus K inverse B square minus K2B, right? So K1A, so because A dissociation into B is proceeded with K1. So K1A minus K inverse B square. Why minus? Because it will be product to reactant minus K inverse B square. Why we are taking square? Because 2 moles of B formed, that's why it can be taken as the square. Then minus K2B. So here K2, B to C product formation proceeded with K2, that's why K2C can be taken. Right. So here half, if you are removing half, what happens? dB by dt is equal to, it can be taken as square will be given, right? That square can be taken here. So that square can be taken here, 2K1A minus 2K inverse B square minus K2B. So this is the final equation what we are requiring from this question. For question number 55, 2K1A minus 2K inverse B square minus K2B, that is provided in the option number 2. For question number 55, option number 2 is the correct answer. By this entire series completed, question number 36 to 55 completed. Hope it will be helpful for you. Thank you very much for your patience listening. Thank you, one and all.